Hey Gottfieles, today we're going to talk about Candida and fruits. Is it possible that fruits can feed Candida or make your Candida overgrowth worse? For example, if you eat like 10 bananas per day. In this video, we're going to talk about the 5 most common mistakes that I see us making when it comes to eating fruits while you're having Candida or other gut issues. After watching this video, you're going to know exactly how to incorporate fruits into your daily diet so they actually support you to get rid of Candida faster and you are prepared, you know what the common mistakes are, so you can avoid them. Guys, if you're new to this channel, my name is Peggy from peggysherman.com. Warmly welcome you here to Gut Feelings, the channel to support you to become your own health expert, so you know what's happening inside your body and you can go out there, take your freedom back, take your energy back, and are able to share your unique gifts with the world out there. Short answer for the question, can the sugar or the fruits in by itself feed Candida or any pathogens in your body? No, never ever. But there are 5 common mistakes that I see us making when it comes to including fruit more into our diet, getting away from the fruit fear. Don't eat sugar, don't eat fruits. Number one, and guys, this is the baseline. If we talk about Candida, you need to know this. Candida is not your enemy. This yeast is naturally present in our body. The only reason why it's overgrowing is because it's an alarming signal. Yeah, it says something, it's a symptom. If you want to understand a little bit more about what's underneath the surface of the iceberg, because that's really the cause. The Candida is the symptom. Make sure you check out the other videos I have on Candida, Candida cleanse, what Candida really means. I put them in the description below so you can watch them after this one. For this video, I'm just going to give you the crisp, short nugget that you need to know. Candida is not the issue, it's a symptom, and we need to address the root cause. If you haven't seen any of the other videos before, the job of Candida is to protect your body from the toxic waste that pathogens like strep, it's a bacteria, or Epstein-Barr, which is a virus, produce in your body. So whenever a virus or bacteria is fed through the foods we eat, through toxic heavy metals, through all kinds of pesticides, medication residues, it also excretes something, a toxin, which is even more damaging than the bacteria or the pathogen itself. And this is what Candida feeds off. So if you have Candida overgrowth, the right step is not to look how to get rid of Candida, but to look how to address this pathogen issue, what's under the iceberg. Candida is not the issue, it's a symptom, and we need to address the root cause. Common mistake number 2, we eat non-organic produce. For example, bananas are often highly treated with pesticides, with toxins, and they are treated very early on, so they actually get through the skin and get into the fruit. Pathogens feed off toxic heavy metals in your liver, in your brain, in your gut. And this is one common mistake that I see when people start including more fruit and then suddenly the Candida symptoms get up. It's because they need to take care of more waste products. Whenever you can, try to eat organic produce. Guys, I completely understand that organic is expensive and maybe you're not even able to access organic produce. That's why I recorded a video how to remove pesticides from the surface of fruits, for example apples or pears or cucumbers or whatever you eat, which is a simple trick. I link the video below. Common mistake number 3, guys, and this one is probably the most important of all of these 5. That has to do with your overall diet. The sugar in fruits does not feed pathogens in your body. Zero. It's the opposite. It helps to kill off bacteria and viruses. If you eat a banana, for example, your blood sugar level rises slowly and it doesn't go really high and then it goes down again. Every fruit comes with their own enzymes which help digest the food and it's going to be absorbed pretty quickly. The fastest is watermelon, then comes banana, and then all the rest of the fruits. But if you are still in a high fat diet or high protein diet and you eat fruit, your blood sugar level will rise higher and it will stay longer on a high level, which then can feed pathogens like Epstein-Barr, strep. Decide what you're going to do. You go either for high fat and high protein or you do the fruit and vegetable diet. When you're on the gut healing challenge, 1-week program that I offer, you're already pointed in the right direction. Just as a side note, there are 2 recipes in the gut healing guide that I invite you to not eat if you want to heal Candida as fast as possible because they contain a little bit more fat. And that is the broccoli and cheese. And that is the broccoli and cheese recipe, which is not real cheese, just so you know. And the second one is the hummus irresistible. And that is because it's high in protein, contains chickpeas, and also contains tahin. If you want to heal as fast as possible from Candida, leave these 2 recipes out and eat a diet that is high in fruits, high in vegetables, and low in fat. So if you're vegan, nuts and seeds, no. Avocado, just a tiny bit. oil zero. If you're a meat eater, you're gonna get off that meat, guys. Even if it's lean meat, it still contains high amounts of protein and high amounts of fat. It's not gonna work if you start including fruits, I can guarantee you that. So the fastest way possible, get rid of the fat, get rid of the protein, you're not gonna die. There's a big campaign with the whole you need more protein, especially if you're vegan. Don't fall into that trap, make your own experience. Mistake number four is that you eat fruits that are not ripe. People who come to me and say, oh, I'm gonna do the banana challenge and the banana island, I'm eating 10 bananas per day, and then I ask them, how do they look, the bananas? And they are green or they're yellow. Fruit need to be ripe. In the case of banana, if the banana is just yellow, they still contain resistant starches which your body can't really handle, and then bloating starts to happen. So if you get bloating from bananas, eat them ripe. And a little extra tip here, secret tip, try to experiment with mono meals. Mono meals are for the body the best thing that you can do because it's easy. It's just one type of fruit, which in and by itself is already a fruit salad with all the different tastes and textures that you have. This is gonna help your body to absorb the nutrients the easiest way possible. It's also low in fat naturally, as all fruits are, apart from avocado, which is low in fructose and high in fat. So mono meals, for example, eat like 10 bananas for breakfast. Yeah, have them in a blender or however much fruit you can eat of one type, and make that a meal. Common mistake number five, we underestimate how incredibly detoxifying fruits are. Especially if you eat them with a low fat, low protein diet and focus on mono meals, they are incredible pathogen killers, they are antiviral, antibacterial, they are dense in nutrients, they are literally vitamin bombs. Yeah, so if you think about vegetables as mineral bombs, that you can think about fruits as vitamin bombs. For example, containing high amounts of vitamin C, which is a natural killer from pathogens and a booster of energy and a supporter of your immune system. A common mistake I see is that people start including these fruits and then they come back and say like, oh, my candida symptoms actually get worse. And the reason why this is happening is because your body starts to detoxify. And again, candida takes care of the waste products. So if a bacteria or a virus dies, it also takes care of the waste products and binds to them and eats them up. So then candida can spike. There's one amazing tip that I can give you if you want to help your body to get rid of the toxins that are now in your bloodstream, yeah, coming out of your liver, coming out of your gut, coming out of the micro pockets in your brain, especially mercury and other toxic heavy metals, and then they get released into the bloodstream. Now, what often happens is that if the body isn't able to deal with the toxicity in the blood and really bind onto something where it can excrete that safely through the body, then your liver can reabsorb the toxins. Best thing to do is Hawaiian spirulina, which is an algae. Apart from being like nutrient dense and containing vitamin B12 and zinc, it's also a binder, it's like a sponge. So whenever spirulina meets a toxin in the bloodstream, it will sponge them up and help your body to get rid of the toxins in a safe way. I link you the Hawaiian spirulina below, also a video if you want to know more about that. Start with 5 tablets per day, and then you can increase up to 10 tablets per day. Okay, short and sweet, the 5 most common mistakes. Number 1 is we think that candida is the problem while it's actually just a symptom. Number 2, we eat a high fat and high protein diet together with fruits which spike our blood sugar levels. This is able to feed pathogens. So low fat, low protein diet, really key here to heal. Check out the Candida Cleanse video if you want to know more about that. Third mistake, we eat non-organic produce or we don't clean them, the pesticides of them, which actually are able to feed pathogens and then make candida overgrow. Number 4, eating fruits that are not ripe. And number 5, underestimating the detoxing power of fruits. If you want to do something about that, include Hawaiian spirulina, which is much more than just a superfood. It's going to help your body to safely transport out the toxins that get released through this detoxing effect from eating more fruits. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was valuable to you and answered your question. I invite you to do 2 things right now. First, please share this video with somebody where you feel, oh my god, this person might actually struggling with the same thing as me. And the second one, I'm making this video for you. Please let me know what I can do better in the comments below. Maybe you have a video idea or you just have, please don't do this, please talk more about that. Let me know in the comments below. I'm grateful for every constructive feedback. Doesn't all have to be praise. Now guys, go out there, eat fruits, eat low fat, eat low protein, do the candida cleanse. I know you can do that, and I'd love to see you in the next video. Bye bye.